this is where we normally stamp our logo. Mm-hmm. We use this machine. Mm-hmm. We call it embossing machine. Mm-hmm. We normally make plates like this. It's a hot plate, aluminium, mm-hmm. imported from UK, but we do locally. Mm-hmm. It has to have a voltage of 200 and above voltage. Mm-hmm. So it's a very hot element. Yeah?
Okay.
So we normally use that. And this man is there, he's the one who do the embossment for us.
So the hot plates are going to be embedded on the leather that we have?
Yeah.
Okay, so when you say embossing, you're actually putting your own logo to what your product?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Let's find out how he does it. So is it electrically connected or is it...
Yeah. You have to be very careful when he's doing the embossment because if it go off center, just a ruined leather, now wastage.
Oh,
yeah.
So if it goes wrong here, the entire leather is wasted.
Normally, when he get the leather from the sablers, mm-hmm. he have to make sure the machine is hot. Mm-hmm. That's the first thing.
Mm-hmm. And it's heated to what degrees?
At 220. Mm-hmm. So you have to check the thickness of the leather so that it sets the gauge here mm-hmm. of the drop of the machine. Mm-hmm. So after he knows the gauge and the temperature, it's all right. That's where he marked the bag, mm-hmm. put the plate, and then drop the machine.
Okay.
Yeah.
So he only has to do one side?
Yeah, only
and that's
one
his
side.
Bid.
Yeah.
Okay.
We don't know. And goes on the hair on because mm-hmm. it can burn.
So this is going to help the person who's going to be assembling the front and the back to know where to do the
markings mm-hmm. and the stitching line. Mm-hmm.
Does it depend on the kind of leather that you're going to be using for her to do the changes on the settings?
Yeah, uh-huh. Like hair on, it's very tricky to style. Mm-hmm. So she has to be very careful.
Yeah, and actually not ruin the leather that you're using?
Yeah. Okay. Now after she do the styling, mm-hmm. take them to the assembling table.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay, she's Catherine. She's one of our assemblers. Mm-hmm. She's what normally they do, they have to check all the patterns, all the parts were cut. Mm-hmm. So Catherine go through the bags to see whether all the patterns are cut and the pieces of the leather.
So at this point is where she has to check that everything is accurate.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Accurate, checked, mm-hmm. and all the beaten pieces are there.
Okay.
Yeah. This is a contact glue. We use a contact gun machine. Mm-hmm. That's what we call it. Now she's preparing the handles. We normally thicken the edge of the handles because mm-hmm. when we come to stitch, put it on the main panels, the stitching will come out very neatly.
Okay.
Yeah.
So she has to do the assembling so that the stitcher who's going to be stitching can know where exactly to go through.
Yeah. And then after she assembled this, we have to take it back to the cutting mm-hmm. to trim the edge.
So normally everything has to come down to the stitching person.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You can tell us a bit about what she's doing.
Now she's stitching the handles on the main body. Mm-hmm. After she has completed stitching the handles, she's going to join the bag together.
Okay. Thank you.
and then it's very tricky to stitch the hair on because it's so slippery.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So she has to make sure she checks on the edges.
Yeah. Take back to the assemblers to turn it off. She normally checks, cut the edge thread, check whether there was over gluing of the back, check the quality of the stitching, and then after that, bind the thread and pack it. There is no problem. If there is a problem, you have to go back to the assembly table, back to the machine, and then you start the process again.
All over again.
Yeah.
Wow. So they all have to be very careful and work as a team to ensure that a bag, when it comes to the finishing table, doesn't actually go back.
Yeah.
Okay. So the first thing she's going to be doing, can take us through?
The first thing she's going to do, she'll cut this. She normally cut and burn, just to stop the lining of the thread.
Okay.
Yeah. Check the quality. I normally come later and then I check again.
Okay.
Yeah, before we pack.
Also, there has to be confirmation that everything is okay
before
it's actually packed to the end.
Sometimes sometimes we end up getting the glue on the fabric. This is what we used to do. We normally used to remove the glue in the fabric, but in leather we can't use the home dry.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what is this called, the liquid that you're using to remove
home
the
dry?
Home dry.
Yeah.
Okay. So if it's fabric, what do you use?
We use this one for fabric. But leather we don't use. We have to use to dry and use the bone folder.
Okay.
Yeah. So we check. I normally come back, check, check. Because normally the zip, it's supposed to run from left to right. Yeah?
Okay.
I normally come, check the zip, or the zip are lining okay. I check the inside, whether the zips are okay, check the position of the lining. And then if I approve it, so we are. After the approval, everything is okay, we pack it, ready to go to the store or to the client. So she's going to pack, how we normally pack the bag, Margaret. You. All the bags have to go to a polythene bag.
Okay.
Yeah.
So this is just your way of packaging every bag
in,
on its own unique way.
Every bag has to go to a bag. You're not supposed to fold it. Now after that, you put them in the box, they need to go to the store or to the client.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's our lovely bag.
And with that, the bag is finally over. Okay.
Yeah.
I hope you've enjoyed seeing the making of this beautiful bag. and the hard work that actually goes to the making of these beautiful bags. So the next time you see a handbag as pretty as this one, of course you know how it's made and where it's made. God bless you for staying tuned to MBCI TV. Till next time, same place, same time. God bless you.